beyond excited to see this PSA grade return. By the way, I got another PSA grade return coming, I want to say within the next week and a half-ish. Because I got a notification, actually, where I got upcharged through Ludkins, which is a service I used before, to send myself the PSA. I sent them a bunch of, like, submissions, like, a year ago, and they're all kind of slowly getting done. I mentioned it before. But look, this time, I got bigger slabs, and I'm very, very excited about these, because these are actually booster packs. Yes, in case you didn't know, you can actually grade booster packs as well. Whoop, as I'm messing up my set in the background, you could actually grade booster packs as well. So what I did is instead of opening up light packs, because there's really no point, I grabbed all my best looking light packs, and I sent them in to get graded back in, I want to say like February. Might have even been March. And I've never graded packs before, but the thing is I've always wanted to slab up packs because I think they look really, really cool in these new cases. For example, this very first one, as you can see, these look great, but this is the first time I'm holding these in hand. It feels kind of weird because it's like really, really thick, as you can see. It looks like it opens up, but it doesn't. I never liked the old cases that they had because they felt clunky. They also bent the top of the packs, which kind of was like weird to me. And I thought it was pretty stupid. So let's actually go ahead and pop in this first one. Ooh, we got a Suicune pack. I actually bought these from Troll and Twit a while back. I don't think these are going to hit 10s. Maybe 8s, maybe 9s. And for the first one, we got... Wait. We got 10 on this? But why? What are the criteria for... What is the criteria for this? Because look, it's like bent. Okay. So, like I said, I've never graded packs before. It's weird to me. Like, the fact that you can grade packs, I don't understand. I watched, actually, PokéRev's video the other day, and there's some packs that got, like, 8s and 9s, and then some that got 10s, that all look the same. So, what is it about this that... You know what? I'm not going to complain. I bought these from Troll and Toad, and I believe these were light. Question mark. You never can tell sometimes unless you actually open it, and unless you have, like, the weights of the boxes. But I remember at the time, I think I bought, like, 6, and they all weigh the same, and I've opened one of the packs, and it ended up having light stuff. I actually pulled a first edition Lugia out of that, the non-holo one. So I was like, you know what? Maybe I should just get these graded, and I include them in this batch. But I'm happy about that. I did not expect to get a 10 on that. All right. Now, I will say... There are two grades in it that I already know because I got upcharged a lot. And because I'm actually got upcharged, I know what the grades are. I'm very, very happy about those. So we got Entei. So this is gonna be a 10 too, right? No, this is a 9! But look. Fair enough. I just wanna understand what makes them be 10 sometimes and what makes them be 9s. Because these came from the same batch. And honestly, I'm gonna keep it real with you. Look at that. This Entei looks way cleaner. Cause like, look, you see like a little folds at the top. It looks way cleaner than the Suicune. I don't understand. I just wanted to get these slabbed up just because, again, some of my favorite packs. I mean, it's nice to hang them up on walls and stuff like that. Like, I have some blister packs and things like that, but having them to slab, it hits different. Ooh, is this it? Is this it? You see that? First edition, Shadowless. And you guessed it. It's a 10. It is a 10. I'm blown away that I own this. And not just that, but check this out. Ready for this? Bruh. Bro, I am so ecstatic about this. Again, I was mostly worried about this than anything. Is that? What is this? Bro. It's like a smudge inside the case. Yo, PSA. PSA, we gotta talk about your quality control. Are you kidding me? Bro, what is that? It's like a scratch. So what this is it's like a double case, basically, the way that they seal it. And it's like a little scratch. It doesn't bother me that much, but it's like a scratch on top of the second layer or something like that. It's weird. By the way, as you can see, they're up to like 65 million right now, somewhere in that neighborhood for like the grades. This shows you how long I submitted these and how long it's been in the system. But I'm so excited about this. Not only is a Charizard a 10, but the Blastoise is a 10, and these were expensive. I remember when I got the upcharge email, even though I hate that they do this, I remember I got so annoyed and I got excited at the same time. I'm like, if it's this much, there could only be one grade for this. And I ended up looking because I had no choice. But I'm hype about this. I am so hype about this. Like, because I bought this from if you guys remember, I bought this from PokéRev's box break like a year and a half ago, 2 years ago. And I still have the second pack, which weighs sort of heavy, but not really. I want to open it, but I'm afraid to open it. This is the by far the lightest of the packs, and I figured let's just get it graded and see what happens. And it worked out. It absolutely worked out. I'm keeping this forever. All right, what else is in here? Let's see what the rest of the grades are. I don't know any of the other numbers. We got a first set pack. First set. I was just base set pack, and it is another 10? Yo! Okay. Oh, it's got the same thing. Maybe this is just how the plastic is, like, made. It's not like a smudge. It's like, I don't even know what to call it. But this is dope. Does anybody know how they dictate what gets a good grade? I mean, these were all from Box Fresh. I remember, I forgot where I bought this one because it's been so long. I forgot where I got this one from, but they all came from like the same source. All the good packs I submitted. And I sent the cleanest looking ones, but I don't know. Like, do they dictate the angle of the cuts, scratches? I have no idea. But hey, I'll take that. This is dope. This is nice. You know what? Hold on. I gotta have this in the background. You gotta hang out in the background because this is just dope to me. And the Blastoise too. You know what? You can both hang out. I like how we're just gonna block out the sealed games in the background for this. But look, you gotta understand. This is historic. This is a piece of history right here. All right. For the next one, we got. I believe this is Aquapolis. I got this from. You know what's funny? I was looking for this pack for a long time. I'm like, don't I have an Aquapolis pack sitting somewhere? And I couldn't find it. And I actually forgot that I sent it to get graded. Because I had two. I had a Tyranitar pack and I had the Scizor pack. And I believe I opened the Tyranitar pack a while back and then pulled nothing out of it. And then for this one, I figured since they were the same weight, just get it graded. And we got an 8! Alright! What makes this an 8? Well, actually, I can kind of see it. I think I can see it. This one has more like light scratches on the actual booster pack. And then of course the bends, if they count that, I don't really know, but yeah. Okay, the next, by the way, these cases look amazing. Like in person, they look amazing. I got Aerodactyl, was actually one of my favorite artworks. Aerodactyl and Zapdos is what I love for Fossil. 9! So we're getting the lower grades and the ones I didn't really care about as much. Again, I don't know what you can count towards the points, but you can see maybe it's got that little cut mark over there and like a little, I don't know what to even call it. Maybe that's what it is. All right, the next one. Oh, this is Neo Genesis. I recognize those backs immediately. So with these, I really want these to come back as tents. You wish and you get your wish. You make a wish and it gets granted. Ooh! I was so worried about this because I saw TCA Gaming submitted his packs a while back and they came back open. I don't know what happened, like maybe because of the storage for a while. Maybe the packs, the way they were pushed down in the box. I have no idea what actually happened. But the second I saw his packs were open during the process, I was afraid. I was like, please don't. But again, what counts as, how do you count these 10s? I mean, yeah, the pack looks great, and I guess maybe they don't count the folds, because on the old grading systems, they would actually fold them. So maybe it's all based on what's right here. And this part does look clean. And then the back has these like little bends. But if I remember correctly, almost every single Neo Genesis pack looks like this. And we're going to see it here in a second when we get to the other ones, because I know I submitted all my good-looking Neo Genesis packs. We got another base set pack. I said this solely because I wanted to send one with the sticker. It's a 9. Does the sticker not take away the points? Honestly, the sticker is what made me want to get this graded, because I want to have one encapsulated that has a sticker that shows you like the $2.50 of what it used to cost back in the day. So that's kind of cool. That's dope. Yo, okay. This is a 9 though. I'm curious. I'm curious if it's a 9 because of the sticker or something else. Is it possible to get a 10 with a sticker? I don't know. Again, see? Every Neo Genesis pack looks like this. Every single one. Happy about that one. I think I sent 2 Lugias in, if I remember correctly. That's exciting. That is exciting. Yeah, these cases look super clean, man. Super clean. Yep. This is probably gonna be a 9 though. If I got 10 on that one, it's gonna be a 9. Or it's a double 10. That works for me too. These came straight from a box. These all came straight from a box. So that's why. I'm gonna assume if you get packs straight from a box, you have a much better chance of submitting them, getting them 10s. But then again, we had that Suicune pack that came back as a 10, and it does look like a 10 to me. I don't know. We have another base pack. I got Venusaur, And another mint 9. Okay, I don't mind that. I don't mind that. Because, I mean, I got the 10s in the back. I'm already happy. Like, nothing can happen in this opening that's not going to make my day than it already is. Like, this is so dope to me. Look at that. Why did I send a Venusaur pack? That's kind of funny to me, actually. You would think I would send other packs. I mean, I was limited to what packs I had that were still light that I, like, cared about. But, yeah. Entei. Is it possible we got a 10 on the Entei? Raikou. Wow. No, we got a 9. And again. See, this is the part where it's confusing to me. Because check this out. Check this out. The front of this is so clean. Like, the Entei pack that came at 9 was a bit, like, not as clean. But this is so clean. And then I don't know, again, what counts towards it. But, again, all the Neo-era packs had these, like, little folds. So that's definitely not it. All right, last one. I believe this should be Feraligatr, right? Yep. I saw the G sticking out. We got another 10. Notice I didn't send Meganium. I did not send a Meganium pack. That's actually funny to me. Ooh, I'm so happy about this. This is cool. I'm never gonna get packs graded again because I don't care. I just have to get these specific ones. Like, I'll be real. I only wanted to send these in right here. And then I didn't want to send, you know, just two packs. I had to send more in. So I sent, you know, some of my more favorite ones that I had around that time. But I'm never going to get packs graded again because I don't care. But having these encapsulated is just so cool to me. So cool to me. So yeah. Stay tuned for more. Like I said, I should be getting another PSA return very, very soon. And I'm very excited about this next one because, I have no idea what's inside it. But I did get an upcharge. And I saw what that upcharge was because they automatically show you in the emails, which I wish that they wouldn't. It is what it is. But I'm excited about that. It's nothing too crazy, but it's a card that I wanted for a while. And I took a chance buying a raw, and it came back as a 10. So I'm excited about that. With that said, let me know your thoughts. What's your favorite pack that's shown here? And I guess I'll see you guys in the comment section below. Peace.